Okay, this is J.D. Dishman. This is Drawing with Autism. And yeah, I'm back to finish what I was starting. Oops. Okay, let's get this done. Put the oops. If you're wondering, today I'm just coloring in the line art. Yeah, no, that's not gonna be skin. I'm just, well, let's just use the same color. You know, let's just use some little. Sheesh, they're crazy. Okay, we'll skin this done. I'm almost getting this done. Ugh. Oh, that's right. I've been using the That's annoying. Almost done. Oh, man, this is getting annoying. Done. Okay, almost getting it done. There. Looks good. That's supposed to be steam, by the way. This is pretty cool. I'm still learning how to use this strategy to shade. Yep, just trying to find the right balance between brush size. Ghost Adventures. Ugh. Oh well. Yeah, Ghost Adventures. Well. Trying to get this done. Bop, 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 bop. Thank you. almost done. Almost done. DVD. Thank you. almost done. Almost done. Okay. If you're wondering, I'm doing my shadow trick, just, you know, doing it a little differently. I'm using the spray paint tool for the softer shadows, and for the harder shadows, I decided to use the Well, you'll see it in a minute. Basically, I'm just using them in one single layer. Then I'll do a few more darker shadows using just this, you know, can trick. Balance it out, and you know, I'll just leave the hair, the tail with this. I still haven't, you know, decided on. Let me just check. I'm just doing this on the characters. Good. Before you're asking, this is gonna be more of a overall. Okay, that's already done. Now let's add the white. So let's plan all. Yeah, that's right. I was gonna line up these shadows I just put in. The idea was to, you know, see if I can make it look cool and. There we go. Gives it a little bit more grayish values. Now let's add in a little bit of more white in the edges so that way. Okay, let's add in the edges the more lighter, because I was going to combine those two. But now I'm going to combine this. Okay, trying to create some kind of white value layer just to. Just a second. A little bit more. it off. Just need to If you noticed, I'm doing a change to the style. It's because I'm experimenting with this new color and technique. It probably won't be introduced until, you know, I want to create a color version of the of event. It's an 8 chapter, you know, what I'm doing. Yeah. The Evasion 2013 kind of thing I'm doing. Right, you could just adjust it. There we go. Let's add a little bit more over here just to Okay, let's go over here just to decrease it by a couple. Mark. Okay, good. So for 29, we'll just sit down to 14. Yeah, this looks good. Looks very better. Okay. Okay, let's go back to the concern that all this is dark as heck. I don't really need to do that except for these buildings and stuff. I don't need to do any. Also gives me kind of a minimalistic approach. You know, something this will work. I mean, a little research on they're done in Sin City, you know. This is kind of a good neo-noirish style for the comic book. Gives it a neo-noirish style to Kunine. You know, if I do a Kunine comic strip, or at least a test strip, I'll probably just gonna do this way. Maybe I should do some experimentation before I do a comic book. Just to be on the safe side. And yeah. There we go. We're done for the day. Anyway, I've been thinking about doing the Kunine series, but haven't exactly got an idea. Maybe I'll just do it like an origin style, like Batman Begins, but after a specific point, so that way it's gonna fill in the points, what's going on and everything, or something similar. I don't know. Anyway, this is JD Dishman, Drawing with Autism, signing off. Peace, my comic otaku. Bye.